Wait, he's gonna come on Skype right now. They're connected, they're calling him, he's not answering. I don't know why they don't know the sound engineer. He's gonna talk definitely first. I don't even know. He can't come on trip. Look at the crowd like,
yeah,
Go here.
mad.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the founder of the real estate welcome show, Mr. Bill Sanker.
Are you guys ready? Are you guys ready? Is it Mr. Worldwide? Oh, wait, he came to quit boxing this morning, had a class. Anyway, let's go to the video. Football video.
I'm not the best rapper. I don't want to be the best rapper. But goddamn it, I'm the hardest worker.
And more than anything, being in Miami boy, first generation Cuban American,
I love the fact that I grew up an underdog. I didn't graduate high school. I probably went to school. But it was a teacher that changed my life. She thought it was a fight going on. She broke through it. She saw me rapping. And she said, do you have talent? My first major concert.
Look at get this.
Oh, sorry. The more I heard no, the more I was like, I gotta fight for this. I believe in this. My half is to get up every day and look life in the face and go, please, what you got, baby?
Come on. I was tell people, there's no losing, only learning. There's no failure, only opportunities.
And there's no problems, only solutions. It all depends on how you want to switch.
You can sit up there with somebody and look at you and say, how did that you get there?
We can talk to everybody in the universal language.
We created a new name, it's called Total Block.
We all bleed the same blood, breathe the same air, and put our pants on one leg at a time. I feel about the Latin community. I don't ever leverage it. No, I am it.
We went back to one of our neighborhoods, Little Havana, in Miami, and we opened a school called Slam. It means the world to me because you see these kids and you see you. This isn't a gimmick, this isn't propaganda. I'm up here because it works. I live it every day of my life.
And that, folks, is how you take a negative and turn it into a positive.
It was all a dream. Now I just wake up and live it. Thinking that the sky was the limit. Until I figured out there's footprints on the moon. Now I'm like, get up and wave, beats the moon.
First of all, I just want to say thank y'all so much. I appreciate the opportunity. I know y'all came out here to party and have a good time, but we're going to get loose and get off the channel. We're going to do that. But the reason that I'm taking on these opportunities is because I feel like we're living in a society where everybody thinks that shit comes easy. They believe in instant gratification. And I like to hit the stage and let y'all know how fucked up, how hard, every time I fell and got knocked out, and had to come right back up and do it all over again in order to be on the stage and be able to do what we've done all around the world. Thank God for that. So I want to start off by thanking Bill Zanker for somebody that believed in me and giving me this opportunity. And I'm going to break down, yes sir, I'm going to break down my story real quick so that you guys see how we got here. So first of all, yeah, they know me as Mr. 305, Mr. Worldwide, Big Boy. But my name is Alejandro Benton Pitts. My family calls me Randy. Yawella calls me Andy. Now, me being a first generation Cuban American. I want to say about some very powerful people. So, abuela, which is grandmother, somebody that would make me inside with five of café con leche, that means some butter bread, coffee and milk in the morning, That same person who did that for me, those small things in life, was one of the first rebels in Cuba next to Castro, what they call the Santa Maria. When it was the revolution in Cuba. When she figured out, whoa, Castro was not the one I should be pushing. Her and my aunt got together, Fianna, which is also somebody like a mother to me. And made me total café con leche, pan con tomate, piqué, arroz, frijoles, platanito, aguacate. They got together and they started creating safe houses for the opposition, which was Batista. Well, she got caught, so she became a political prisoner. So when tía and abuela get together, my aunt and my grandmother get together, they trying to figure out how to get the kids out of Cuba. So they hustled into religion, and they got around an operation called Peter Pan. So that's how my mother got to this country. 10 years old, didn't know the language, didn't know where she was going, grandmother didn't know the family, didn't know what was going on, but she knew one thing, they were getting the fuck out of Cuba. Now why do I tell you this brief story right quick? Because those are the three most powerful women in my life. And a woman made me the man, and they're the ones that taught me how to teach. They're the women that gave me the strategy, that taught me that life is chess, not checkers. That it's a marathon, not a sprint. And here's one for you, let them teach you. Paso corto, pita larga. Short steps, long vision. Now my father, which wasn't really a father to me, he became a god later on in life, me and my good friends. But he came over in something that they call the lottery in Cuba. Now here's the funny thing about the lottery in Cuba. You don't win no fucking money, but you win something that's priceless. Freedom. You get a chance to get out. So that's what he won. And when he came over, when I was born January 15th, 1981. More like Capricorn, but that's cool. I mean, what you want me to do? He brought Boto in the Mario boat lift. So anybody that's seen the movie Scarface, you've seen the beginning of that movie, that's what my father was bringing Boto. Why? See, abuela, tía, mi mamá, my father, Fabi, they all believe in something that's so beautiful, so priceless, which is freedom. With that freedom, they gave me the opportunity to be able to be born here in the United States of America. Now, why do I have to give you that story? All right. If we're going to talk about money, if we're going to talk about entrepreneurship, if we're going to talk about what it is, what is the brand, what is the struggle, what is the sacrifice, we all do that for one reason. Freedom. Independence. With that said, is to me, entrepreneurship equals freedom. You only try to do your own business, do your own thing to be able to move how you want to move. We have another saying that says, más vale ser la cabeza de un ratón que la cola de un león. Okay? Which means, it may not look nice, but I'd rather be the head of a rat than the tail of a lion. At least I can hold what I want to do what I want to do. Well, all these lessons, growing up in Miami in the early 80s, and anybody that knows about Miami in the early 80s, it was cocaine capital, murder capital. And my first way of looking at entrepreneurship, well, the first entrepreneurs that I saw that took life. Nothing and made it something.
Life shall Facebook.
With drug dealers. So that's the first thing that I looked at. And I said, wow. So you can take that, flip this, take that, flip that. And the ones that I would say transitioned, mutated, modified from extracurricular activities to legal businesses were the ones that always stayed quiet, always moved under the radar, and little by little, always help the community. So learn from that. It's the same thing I do in the music business. All I do is I have a product. I better make sure it's raw. Only difference is you ain't sniffing it. You listening to it. But what do I gotta do? I gotta make sure if my business
I got 6 seconds to make sure that y'all don't change the channel. 6 seconds. That's what I got. That's why anytime you hear me, you hear it's like, oh, look at this kid. Mr. Worldwide, oh, they go kid, they go kid. So I gotta find ways how to move and navigate in a world that's moving so fast. Now, why don't I tell you a story about me growing up? Because that world came with addiction. Addiction comes with denial, which, by the way, is the longest river in the world. Denial. Right? And what we're living in right now, I feel that we're so connected that we're disconnected. Right? And for people that want to grow in business, people that want to be entrepreneurs, you got to be a leader. You have to lead by example. You have to build a great team. Because if you don't got the right team around you, you might as well give up. All right? You need somebody that share the same vision, to share the same goals. People have to understand that failure is the mother of all success. There's no way, shape, or form are you going to create a business and the sheep just going to jump. Be ready for it. And a lot of people, what do they want with all this? Well, like I learned from the boys in the streets, they want success. Yeah, they want success. They want to be successful and succeed. Right? When you're looking at somebody that deals with a lot of things, fame, money, power, women, a lot of family members that I don't fucking know, but they be popping up all the time. Why do I tell you? Well, if you look at the word success, here's the beautiful thing. Success is the making of the made, and believe it or not, that's the easy part. Succeed is maintaining, that's the hard part. And successful is when you understand what success and succeed embodies. What does it embody? Well, see, success, succeed, and successful all have one thing in common. They begin with the word suck. Suck. Not that it sucks, but everybody trying to suck one way or another. Attorney trying to suck, agent trying to suck, business partner trying to suck, family trying to suck, friends trying to suck, people soaring trying to suck. One way or another, you become a target. So what do I mean by that is, be ready for what you guys are about to embark upon. Empower it. Embody it. My first record that went, and this is crazy, my first record that really went around the world like that was a record called Pulo. For those that don't know what Pulo means, it just means ass. But we made it poetic. My first record goes out, and I get sued for $500,000. And believe me, you ain't gonna have $1,000,000. And I turn to Little John, which is a mentor of mine. I always say, Batman and Robin, he's Batman, I'm Robin. And John turns to me and said, Chico, you know what that is? That means you got a hit record. I said, shit, way to flip it on me, man. So now, when it comes to records, I'm like, if we got sued, shit, it's gonna be a big record. It's all about flipping perspective. And you guys are gonna run into a lot of valleys, peaks, ups, downs, highs, lows. People are gonna do a lot of things as you come up in the game that you know, man, I can't believe this. But always take it in a way where it's leading you somewhere. Okay, like they say, God closes the door to open the window. Now myself, in music, taking this time to come up here and speak to you a little bit about my story is because sometimes, for me, every day I wake up and I say, oh, Dios, gracias a Dios, 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 thank you, Lord, God, bless you. Because it's truly unbelievable how this story works out. From whether my grandparents, my father, my mother coming from Cuba, everything they went through in the 80s, which that'll be a whole other seminar, I can't speak too much about right now. To where we're at right now, where my mother, when I lived in a neighborhood called Kansas City, Miami, okay? And let me tell you something, nobody in Kansas City was fucking checking for no Tony Robbins. I'll tell you that shit right now. Nobody. Two Black Crew, Poison Clan, NWA, you know. It was that kind of party. And my mother would play me into your lives, and she could take me to school. We lived in an efficiency, 82 pink toe, you had to keep the windows down so that shit wouldn't burn up when you get in. Had to be careful you don't hit it from the back because it might blow up. And my mother would put Anthony Robbins when she would take me to school. And here's the funny thing. I went to go touch the radio. I told this story, and I'm going to keep telling it because I want to be programmed in your head. I went to go touch the radio to change it. She hit my hand. Bop. She said, you pay for this car? I said, nah. She goes, then don't touch my radio. And I listened to Anthony Robbins. And by default, you know, he subliminally fucked me. So next thing I know, I'm looking at everything different. Okay? And the story that got me was the Colonel story, which is the Kentucky Fried Chicken story. That it took Buddy 1,007 no's. I just rounded off to like 1,000. You know, even it should be 1,010, but 1,000 sounds better. Imagine 1,007 no's. That's what it's all about. It's not the money, it's the journey, it's the story. It's telling people, like, you know how many times people believe in me or believe in the record? Or tell me, hey, I don't think it's going to work out. Like, when the fuck was the last time that you were in the street or in the club having a good time? Right? They can't tell you what you know. You got to listen, you got to fight for it. So I always remember.